Hi everyone, welcome to the video on calculating the cost effectiveness of antacid using titration. There are two goals to this experiment. One is to determine the amount of acid that can be neutralized by a gram of antacid, and the second goal is to compare two antacids and determine which one is more cost effective. We can determine both of these goals by using acid-base reaction stoichiometry. So let's start by discussing antacids. As you know, these are compounds that you take when you have excess acid in your stomach. As a result, these compounds contain weak bases as their active ingredients, such as aluminum hydroxide, calcium carbonate, and magnesium hydroxide. These bases can neutralize excess acid in your stomach. For example, if the antacid contains calcium carbonate, the reaction with H+, or proton, which is what an acid produces, can be shown here. As you can see, the final product is just water and carbon dioxide gas. It's important to distinguish two terms that's used here. Antacid refers to the tablet that we buy, and active ingredients refers to the actual compounds in the antacid that can neutralize acid. The active ingredient is a small percentage of the antacid tablet. The rest of the tablet is composed of materials such as binders that allow the tablet to be easily digested. Our first goal is to determine how many moles of H+ or acid can be neutralized by 1 gram of antacid tablet. We can do this by carrying a procedure called a back titration. What this process requires is that we add excess amount of acid, in this case HCl, to a given mass of antacid. Because the HCl is in excess, some will be left over after all the antacid has been neutralized. The remaining HCl will then be neutralized by addition of NaOH, in this case using the technique of titration. By using stoichiometry, we can calculate the number of moles of HCl that reacts with the antacid. We can say that there's a certain quantity of active ingredients that neutralizes the HCl. The unit of this quantity is called equivalent, which is a unit that defines the quantity of a substance based on the substance's ability to react with another substance. In this case, one equivalent of the active ingredient is defined as the quantity of active ingredient that can neutralize exactly 1 mole of HCl. You may wonder why we don't just use number of moles for the unit of the active ingredient. The reason is because we don't really know which compounds make up the active ingredients in our antacid. As a result, it's impossible for us to stoichiometrically calculate the exact number of moles. So once we finish our experiment, what we can find out is how many equivalents of the active ingredient is present in a gram of antacid tablet. After we find that number, we can then figure out how much it costs us to buy a certain equivalent of active ingredient. We're going to use the cost information of the antacid to calculate that. Let's work this out in an example. So here, a student reacts 0.326 grams of antacid with excess HCl, and then the remaining HCl is neutralized by NaOH. We're given the cost information and asked to calculate the cost per equivalent of the antacid. So we first have to calculate the number of equivalent of the active ingredient. Remember that this can be done by taking the difference between the total HCl that's used and the HCl that is neutralized by NaOH. So let's do the calculation. To get the total HCl, we multiply the molarity of the HCl by its volume, which gives us 3.346 times 10 to minus 3 moles of HCl. We can then calculate the number of moles of HCl that's neutralized by NaOH. Since HCl and NaOH reacts in a one-to-one stoichiometry, we can calculate the number of moles of NaOH first, which is just its molarity times its volume, and then we multiply that by the stoichiometric relationship between HCl and NaOH that eventually gives us 1.765 times 10 to the minus 3 moles of HCl. Now, subtracting one number from the other and then multiplying by the relationship between equivalent and mole gives us 1.581 times 10 to the minus 3 equivalent of the active ingredient. Now, remember that what we want to know is how much active ingredient we have in a gram of antacid tablet. To do that, we will take the number of equivalents that we just calculate and divide that by the mass of antacid we use in the experiment, which is 0.326 grams. This gives us 4.85 times 10 to the minus 3 equivalent of active ingredient per gram of antacid tablet. Now, the last part is to find out how much all of these cost, okay? So what we will do here is we will take the cost information that we have, which is $5.99 for 100 tablets, and then one tablet weighing 0.65 grams, multiply these two things together, that will cancel out our tablet in this case, and then taking the quantity we just calculate, which is the number of equivalents per gram, and then multiplying that here, which will allow us to cancel the grams out of the equation. So as a result, at the very end, what we have is a quantity that has a unit of dollar at the top and equivalents at the bottom. And for this particular antacid, we get a cost of $19 per equivalent of active ingredient. So this calculation is the one that you will be performing in your experiment today. And what you're going to do is compare the cost effectiveness of two antacid brands. So here I'm giving you the cost information for the two brands of antacid you will use. Your goal is to compare the cost effectiveness of these two brands by calculating the dollars per equivalent for each brand and seeing which one is cheaper. So let's now go through the experimental step. On the right is a picture of the various components of the experiment. So you're going to start with the antacid, get one of the tablets and grind it with a mortar and pestle, which is shown here. And then you're going to weigh a certain amount of that antacid powder as described in your lab procedure. You're going to then dissolve the antacid in HCl, which comes in one of the reagent bottles shown here. Heat that solution, which helps to remove the CO2 that's forming the reaction between the antacid and the HCl. And then to that hot solution, you're going to add bromophenol blue. This comes in a small vial, which is shown here, and is a solution that is needed to help us determine when to stop our titration. You're going to carry out a titration between HCl and NaOH to the end point of bromophenol blue, which is another way of saying until the bromophenol blue changes its color. And then you're going to record the volume of HCl and NaOH that you use in the titration, as well as their respective molarities. Repeat the same procedure again, but with a second brand of antacid. All right, okay, let's now discuss some important details in the experiment. Both the HCl and the NaOH will be delivered using burettes. As usual, when you use burettes, you must clean them before and after use. The procedure to clean a burette before use is shown right here. Basically, what you have to do is first rinse the burette with distilled water, and you want to hold it as shown in the picture here to rinse the burette. After you're sure the burette is clean, which is when no water droplet remains inside the surface, then you're going to rinse the burette with the solution that you're going to use, which is either HCl or NaOH. When you're done with the burette at the end, you want to rinse again with water before you return the burette to the stockroom. Another quick reminder is that you need to flush the air bubbles out of the burette before you use it, otherwise your reading will be wrong. So as I mentioned earlier, when you add the HCl to your antacid, you're going to produce some CO2. This CO2 has to be removed from the solution by boiling. The reason the CO2 is a problem is because it will increase the acidity of the solution and will cause us to titrate with too much NaOH. Now, we want to titrate using NaOH to the equivalence point, which is just the point when the number of moles of NaOH is equal to the number of moles of the remaining HCl. Since both HCl and NaOH are colorless, we use a third substance called an indicator to tell us when to stop titrating. The indicator changes color when the titration is near the equivalence point. The point when the indicator changes color is what we call its endpoint. The indicator we will use today is bromophenol blue, which has the following color. When the solution is acidic, it's yellow. When the solution is basic, bromophenol blue is blue or purple. When it goes from one solution to the other, the color becomes green. So our goal is to titrate until our indicator is greenish or light purple. Now, the color you will see when you have the antacid in there will not be as clear as these colors, but it will still have a greenish or bluish tinge to it. Now, how do we know that we are at the endpoint? As you're adding the NaOH into your solution, you will see a color change as soon as the drop of NaOH hits the HCl, as shown in this picture. But that color will immediately return back to its original color when you mix the solution. So this tells you that you're still far away from the endpoint. As you're adding more NaOH, you will find that the blue color will take longer to disappear after mixing. This is a sign that the endpoint is near. At this point, you want to start adding your NaOH pH drop by drop. When the green or blue color appears after addition of 1 to 2 drops of NaOH and stays for 20 seconds or more, then you know that you have reached the endpoint. The picture here shows the correct way to carry out a titration. One hand should be used to control the buret stopcock, and the other hand should be used to swirl the Erlenmeyer flask as the NaOH is being added. The other thing I want to point out is that each student should do one titration, since in total there are 2 titrations to do in today's lab. Now, because the antacid tablet contains materials beyond the active ingredient, you're going to see that some parts of the antacids won't dissolve, even in the hot HCl solution. This is normal, but you do want to make sure that as much of the tablet is dissolved as possible. Now, note that if you have an intense blue color, it's likely that you have gone way past the endpoint. This doesn't mean that you have to repeat the whole experiment again. What you have to do is reverse the titration. The way you do this is by adding HCl to bring the color of the solution back to yellow. After that happens, you can then slowly titrate back with NaOH to get the color to the endpoint of green or light purple. If you do carry out the reverse titration, make sure you record all the additional volumes of HCl and NaOH that you use.
Okay, let's briefly discuss the safety and waste disposal. As usual, you want to have your complete PPE of goggles, lab coat, and closed-toe shoes. You should combine all unused HCl and NaOH in one beaker, and then discard this waste in the sink because they are non-hazardous. Note that you will need to check out 2 burettes from the stockroom. Rinse and dry them before returning to the stockroom. This concludes the video on this experiment. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in lab.